Alright, welcome back to another video. Today's video, we got a 2018 370Z Heritage Edition, so... inside. Very nice car. One of my favorite colors of all time, yellow. In this case, also from Copart. Dad, if you want to show this side, because that side looks good. This side, not so much. It does have two aftermarket wheels I tossed on because both of them were kind of destroyed, the original ones. So this one, I don't really remember the story, but ended up getting into an accident. So whole apron got hit. Same with suspension. It bent a tie rod, but we replaced that. The door, even the inside got damaged a bit too. Like door seal, I'm not sure what it's called. Pillar, yeah. But it does have four airbags deployed also. Roof, seat, steering wheel, and dashboard. Unfortunately, the dashboard, I hate replacing dashboards, but you gotta do what you gotta do. But the rest of the car looks pretty good. It's got this beautiful exhaust, Tone. If you know, you know. This other side is pretty much immaculate, like no dents or anything. Yeah, really nice. Yeah, it's got a lot of nice aftermarket parts on it. Yeah, just gave it a quick wash. We're basically ready to start taking it apart. I guess take it apart, you know, see the rest of the damage. And then we'll come up with a game plan from there. Maybe we have to put it on a frame machine. We don't know yet. I guess let's start taking it apart and then we'll go from there. Alright, as you just saw, I got that door off, got the sides cut off. We see a lot more of the damage now. What we can tell is this apron definitely shifted. I mean, we knew that. So it does need to go on a frame machine because it does need to be pulled to get this buckle out. Same goes for the inside of the door, buckled there. So we'll figure out something with that. Quarter panel has a dent in it, but that's fixable. So we don't have to replace this skin like the last car we had to. There's the old door, old side skirt. I guess we'll keep taking it apart. I do wanna still take apart this front end because we do need to change the core support. And to do that, you gotta take apart the whole front end. It does also have a aftermarket oil cooler, and it looks like one of the lines actually got hit, so it does have a small oil leak, which I'm probably just gonna delete the whole oil cooler, just put it back to stock. So yeah, I guess from there, let's just keep taking it apart and we'll see if there's any more damage. So we got it all stripped apart, got the radiators off, the core support, no surprises. From what we can see, the passenger side is all good, the apron, the frame rail, none of it like shifted, none of it got damaged. I did delete the oil cooler, also did put all back to stock and no more catch cans, just to make it more simple. Maybe later on after it's on the road, we can install that back, but yeah. New oil, no more oil leak, because one of the fittings did get loose on the oil cooler from the accident and it was had a slow leak. But yeah, from there, from what we can tell, apron needs to be pulled. So we are actually planning on putting on a frame machine right now today to just get this buckle pulled out, get this strut tower, you know, where it's supposed to sit. And yeah, we'll go from there. I did also run to the dealer. I got the apron piece, so we are ready basically for the frame machine to pull this and then replace this piece. And I also did get hood hinges, so basically should have most of the parts to do the frame. Still waiting on like bumper, dashboard, stuff like that, but we'll get into that later. Yeah, but as of now, I guess that's it. Let's get it on the frame rack and we'll go from there.
Good.
Let me put it a little bit more straight.
Thank you.
saw, pretty quick, pretty easy, only what, maybe 45 minutes max. We got the strut tower pulled, which is the reason we put it on the frame machine, is just to get that strut tower pulled. Everything else we could do without our frame machine, like change this apron piece, etc. But Dad, if you want to show it, the strut brace. I didn't use the original strut brace, I used a new one just because in case that one got bent in any way. But all the bolts line up perfect, which is good. Yeah. So that tells the strut tower's straight. I mean, we made a couple measurements. Overall good. Yeah, we ended up cutting out this inner skin. Sorry, it's such like thin sheet metal here. But just to get that inner structure like all straight, which it is all straight in there. Same thing here. So yeah, basically, I mean, that's it for the frame machine. Now we can put it our side of the shop and get replace this apron, you know, fix this, and I guess keep going. Okay. So moving along, we got off the frame machine, got that strut tower where it's supposed to be. I already drilled out like the apron piece, and I got the new piece just in there on a bolt, not welded in or anything yet. But we did do a couple measurements, and it's actually lined up perfectly, like how that one is diagonally. We also did get that door on from a parts car, a door on, and the gap. I mean, we had to mess with it a little bit, but we got the gap like pretty good. Pretty even, like even on the passenger side, it's pretty even. Closes actually really smooth. I mean, the window's rolled up, but yeah, super smooth. So yeah, now we could actually maybe put the whole front end together, get the fender on, get these straightened out. Once the whole front end like lines up, headlights, everything lines up, take it all back apart, we can actually weld up this piece. And then we can actually move on to body work, but we'll get to that. So for now, let's just toss the front end together and we'll go from there. Framework pretty much all done. All we have to do now is weld in that apron. We got the hood, the headlights, the fenders on, basically, and the gap's actually really good. I didn't even take much time to adjust them. Dad, if you want to show some of them, like, I mean, it's only on a couple bolts, like each part, but like gaps are really good. I'm happy. Both sides line up. Yeah, so we got the apron, got the fenders, core support on. Yeah, but one thing is you could definitely see how pushed back this wheel was, because it was hit. And you could barely even see the tire and the fender and the wheel well. So lower control arm, probably like the spindle itself I'll replace too. So we'll work on that probably next video, and we can actually start getting into paint and body work because the quarter panel is dented. So yeah, we got plenty of work left on it, but for the first video, I think this is enough. We got it, you know, we bought a 2018 yellow 370, beautiful car, got it all stripped apart, got it on the frame, Got that strut tower pulled where it's supposed to be. Everything lines up really good. I'm happy. Yeah, next episode we'll work on the next video. We'll work on the quarter. Get it, you know, get everything welded up. Maybe painted, hopefully. So, yeah, that's it for now. Thank you.